Oh, fall. It's the time of the year the Central Texas gardener looks forward to. Some of the best gardening time there is. It's the time of cooler temperatures. Well, sooner or later it'll cool off. It's time for more rainfall. Okay, there's supposed to be more rainfall, but there are definitely fewer bugs to deal with, and it's a much longer growing season. Before you run out and decide to plant a garden large enough to feed a small country, you need to remember a few things. We have to be aware, or maybe that's beware, of the weather. Many of our popular growing calendars may be telling us to plant those carrots or broccoli, but to many folks' surprise, plants can't read. These calendars are reminders for us, not for the plants. We still have to adjust them based on the weather conditions and not the date. The success of those seeds we want to put in the garden right now is very dependent on the soil temperature. Seeds have specific needs to germinate, and one is the proper soil temp. If it is too hot or too cold, they won't get started. Rather than waste your time or wonder if maybe the seeds you have are bad, get a thermometer to measure the soil temperature before sowing. Your local nursery should have one like this for about 10 bucks. Measure the temperature about 3 inches down and make sure it's appropriate for the seed you want to grow. Not sure what the right temp is? Consult your local extension office or a good seed starting book. Planting seed in the wrong temperature of soil is probably the number one reason you have poor or even non-existent germination. So what do you do if you don't have the patience to wait for the soil to cool? No problem. Start the seeds inside. You can get your choices of plants. You can pick them up from your local nursery, and it's much easier to monitor and care for your plants. Some of our fall veggie choices start out as very small, delicate seedlings. One single unexpectedly hot day, which we know never happens in Texas, and our little start can melt away. A sudden downburst of rain can pound it into submission. But starting them inside lets us ensure they get the care and the conditions they need to become a successful start ready to transplant. What's that? You aren't comfortable trying to start your own seeds? Hey, that's not a problem. Head to your local independent nursery and pick up a start. Planting in high temperatures can cause you some serious problems. When the temperatures get too warm for a plant, they do something called bolting. The plant reacts to the stresses and tries to go to seed. When this happens, the plant releases certain chemicals that cause it to be bitter, preventing insects, animals, and people from eating it. Once it gets bitter, there's nothing you can do to reverse it, so pull it up and plant again. And if bolting isn't a problem, certain plants will button. When planted in too high of heat, broccoli, cauliflower, and cabbage will stunt and produce small, if any, heads. And if you think covering it with shade cloth is going to solve the problem, it won't. It's the air and soil temperatures that are causing the problem. No matter how much fertilizer or water you give them, once stunted, you can't correct it, and we go back to pulling the plant and starting over. So don't think of fall as a date. For our garden, fall is a temperature, and for most of our garden, we need to wait until fall is a daily high of 85 degrees or less. Trust me, your plants will appreciate it. Fall really is the best time for us Central Texas gardeners, but we have to realize that the weather, not the calendar, is in charge. To be successful, we have to adjust appropriately. Understanding how seed and soil temperatures work together and recognizing that cool season plants do best when it's actually the cool season makes all the difference between success and disappointment. For Backyard Basics, I'm Jeff Ferris.